things about entrepreneurship. Of course, it's like a wild journey, a lot of adrenaline rush, ups and downs. But I would like to definitely highlight upon a few things that I believe every entrepreneur and every person who aspires to do something in life that they actually love to do would need to follow, or at least there's a few pointers, right? If you look at taking a step back in my life, okay, as a child, I was extremely shy. You know, I used to never go out and play. Always, you know, be at home. You know, not really answer any questions in the class. I was that kind of a kid, to be honest with you. But one thing changed all, and that was basketball. You know, there's this incident that happened when I was in sixth grade, when I so much wanted to be a part of, you know, the school basketball team. And I still remember, I was a very weak child. I was tall, but you know, I was weak. So, you know, I go to this audition, and then there is this PT teacher, who's like a coach, is trying to select. Then he looks at me, he's like, "Vishwas Mudgal, what are you doing here?" Right? So I was really embarrassed. I was like, "Man, you know, what do I do now?" And then he made me run a couple of rounds. By the time I was there to shoot a few shots, I couldn't even do it. So he basically told me in front of the entire class that I can never become a basketball player. I don't know why he told me that, but there were a lot of people there, and I was so embarrassed. I go home, I was hurt beyond imagination. I cried for a couple of days. And then I remember my father telling me that, you know, you become a great basketball player only because, you know, you're going to walk towards it, right? And you want to become, you know, a failure only when you quit. So, you know, nobody's a born master. You got to go towards it, right? So I took it very seriously, that particular incident. And I started practicing basketball in the sidelines, not really in school. I did that for a year, built my stamina, because I realized one thing, that I love basketball. I knew that, I love basketball. So I did that without any hope. For the next year, the seventh grade, it was amazing to see that the same PT, the coach, took me in the same team, because he saw me performing really well, and he really wanted me in the team. And he was a great guy, but you know, I think that push was required for me. You know, he hurting me that time. So, and after 2 months, there was a notice on the notice board. There was a list put up for the team. And then my friends came, and they're like, you know, you need to see this. So I went there and I saw the first name for the captain, name was Vishwas Mudgal, for the team in seventh grade. So that day, I realized one thing, that if you believe you're born to do great things, you will do great things. That's all. You need to believe in yourself. You need to believe in your passions. So my number one advice to any entrepreneur, any person on this earth is this. You need to believe you are born to do great things. Everything starts from there. I can give a lot of gain about entrepreneurship, about products, about business plans, all those things. But if you lack this first thing, that, you know, you don't believe in yourself, in your ideas, in your passions, there's nothing. So that, the game of basketball, that incident changed my life. You know, that's what's the biggest key, I feel, you know. So this incident, things changed with me suddenly. You know, I started becoming more popular in the school, and of course I was good at studies and stuff like that. And and then after, in 12th grade, I came back to my hometown, it's called the North Canada. Then I was doing my schooling in Mysore, I came back. Then I realized that what is happening in Bangalore and Mysore, a lot of advancements happening, and I did not see that, you know, back in my hometown. Then one day I went to my dad and I told him that, you know, I want to start a computer training center for rural kids. Then he was like shocked, like he's like, what? You know, because one day I just go and tell him that, you know, I want to start this, you know, company. And then he's like, where are we going to put up the office? And then I had already found out a place because we had like a complex in the middle of the city. And then who's going to be the faculty? So I had already figured it out. Like, who are going to be the students who will come? So I already figured out how to do it. So now I know what is it called. It's called a business plan. So I back then I did not know what is it called. So but I had kind of figured out a business plan for the entire center, and I set up the first my first company, that was InfoVision Computer Academy, for training rural students in computers. So that was great learning for me, and there was nobody to guide me in that. But there was only a desire to do something cool, something good, you know, in the society at that point in time there. So I think the rule number two in entrepreneurship is 110% guts. You need to have guts to walk that extra mile, you know, in what you believe in. So I believed in setting up a center there. I believe that that's what's going to work, that's solve a real problem in that area, and I did that. And the center ran for a few years. A lot of kids, you know, were trained there. It's a very, very fulfilling aspect, and it really taught me a lot.